Hello children, Assalamualaikum. So here is part 2 of this book, Rana Liaqat Ali Khan, which I had originally written in Urdu. And it is part of this graphic stories series of eminent Pakistani personalities, right? And this is translated by Amna Asfar, the English version. This particular book is, illustrated by Aslam Bashir, and the series is published by Oxford University Press. So, like I had said before, that these books I will be doing in two parts. We now come to this page where the first conference of women leaders and activists is taking place, and here is the picture in the book about this, and let me read it to you. So Rana Liaqat Ali Khan, Begum Rana Liaqat Ali Khan, the wife of the Prime Minister of Pakistan, the first Prime Minister of Pakistan, she is saying, educating one woman is like educating her whole family. Today, Lady Nusrat Haroon and I announced the establishment of, a very important institution was founded that day. She said, we are announcing the establishment of All Pakistan Women's Association, which we can call by its acronym, APWA. We believe that it has three important goals: one, health; two, education; and three, training. If our women are educated and become independent, they can tackle any problem confidently. Our women are working well in different fields and we are proud of them. The rest of our sisters also need good health, education, and honorable professions. So, by 1955, 32 branches of APWA had opened across both wings of the country, meaning West Pakistan and East Pakistan. They were training 40,000 women through different stages of their professions every year. At this point, APWA had 100 social welfare centers, 60 dispensaries, and 13 organizations for elementary education, which benefited an additional 15,000 women. Okay? Now, this was then, remember, this we are talking about the 1950s, and obviously the numbers then became larger. Okay, Pakistan's first Prime Minister, Qaid-e-Millat Liaqat Ali Khan. So here in this picture, this illustration, you see that Qaid-e-Millat is addressing a public rally, people, and this is where he was killed. So let's read about it. Pakistan's first Prime Minister, Qaid-e-Millat Liaqat Ali Khan, was killed by a gunman's bullet on 16th October 1951 in Company Bagh, later renamed Liaqat Bagh, in Rawalpindi. The assassin, Saad Akbar Babrak, was immediately shot dead by a policeman. Nobody knows to this day who was behind the conspiracy to kill the Prime Minister. So that was a very tragic thing that happened. There's one other picture over here. You see that? Okay. So this news was brought to Begum Rana Liaqat Ali Khan in Karachi. She was not there in Rawalpindi. Her children, both her sons, were also in Karachi. And so this picture, the second picture over here, this one. Madam, as Home Secretary, I've been assigned a task that is very painful for me. You need a great deal of courage to hear this news. The Prime Minister of Pakistan was assassinated in the public meeting in Rawalpindi. So the Home Secretary himself came to the house in Karachi and informed Begum Rana Liaquat Ali Khan. Remember, there was no television then, there were no cell phones then, there were no computers, no internet, you know. This is how he informed her. And you can see in this picture the two sons of Liaquat Ali Khan, Rana Liaquat Ali Khan. They are doing their studies, they are probably doing their homework, and this lady who was the governess, who was looking after the boys, she comes in and says, "My brave boys, your mama is in the next room, let's go to her. Your father has been shot." And the boys say, "Miss Miles, no. Billy, no. Daddy is alive. I want to go to Mama." "Billy, what are you saying? That's not possible. You must have misunderstood," says the other one. They are young. They are very young boys when their father was shot dead. The assassination of Liaquat Ali Khan was a terrible tragedy for Pakistan, but even at a time like this, Rana Liaquat Ali showed great courage and kept the country united. Okay. Shortly after the creation of Pakistan, organizations such as Pakistan Women's National Guard, PWNG, and Pakistan Women Naval Reserves were established. The Pakistan Army conferred the uniform and honorary title of Brigadier General on Rana Liaquat Ali Khan for rendering military services as a civilian. And here are those pictures, and in this picture over here, she's saying, "All of you should continue to render services for the defense of the country with hard work and courage." And now we come to this page, which is also an interesting one over here. The former First Lady of USA, Eleanor Roosevelt, laid the foundation stone of a women's college founded by Rana Liaquat Ali. Later, this college became known as Rana Liaquat Ali Khan Government College of Home Economics. So this is in Karachi, and other such colleges were also opened in Lahore and in Dhaka. The Ford Foundation and APWA provided the capital for this college. We are happy that the wife of the former American president has come to Pakistan at the invitation of Begum Rana Liaquat Ali to lay the foundation stone of the college. Okay, so this college, of course, exists to this day. And now here there's another meeting that she is heading, and let's see what it is about. She's saying, "It is a matter of joy that today we have established the Business and Professional Women's Club for working women of different professions, which will prove to be of great help to its members. I am happy also that Friends of APWA and the International Women's Club too are soon to be established. We need to do a lot more work for Pakistan." Okay, now another picture, another page, and here, Rana Liaquat Ali Khan was ambassador to the Netherlands from 1954 to 1961, and to Italy and Tunisia from 1961 to 1966. Before her departure from the Netherlands, Queen Juliana conferred on her the Grand Cross of Orange Nassau. And here the two boys are saying, "Mama, you've been made Pakistan's ambassador to the Netherlands. It means you will be the first woman ambassador of the Muslim world." And she says, "Akbar, that is so, but remember that it is not easy to represent your country ably in a foreign land. However, your mother accepts this challenge gladly. They are in their home, the boys are happy, and she says that, you know, one has to work very hard when you are in a position such as that. So Rana Liaquat Ali Khan worked all her life for the education, health and economic welfare of the people of Pakistan, especially women. She left behind much that lit the path of for Pakistani women. In 1952, she became the first woman from a Muslim state to address the United Nations. Rana Liaquat Ali Khan was made governor of Sindh in 1973 and held this office until 1976. She was Pakistan's first woman governor and was also chancellor of Sindh and Karachi universities. In 1978, she was given the United Nations Human Rights Award. Pakistan's Nishan-e-Imtiaz was among the many national and international awards that were conferred on her. So, here is a class of, women students. There is a teacher, and she says, Rana Liaquat Ali Khan established Gulerana Nusrat Industrial Center, Gulerana Nusrat Community Center, and a big Pakistan cottage industry shop on Abdullah Harun Road. In addition, the Liaquat Model Colony was built for craftsmen. The Nusrat in the names of these establishments reminds us that Lady Nusrat Abdullah Harun figured prominently in founding APWA. Along with Rana Liaquat Ali, Nusrat Harun was a great social worker. Even during Rana Liaquat Ali Khan's long absences from the country because she was a diplomat, these organizations continued to function smoothly as she continued to guide them from abroad. During the last 12 years of her life, Rana Liaquat Ali Khan remained busy with social welfare activities despite old age and poor health. She died on 13 June 1990 and was buried next to her husband within the premises of the Qaid-e-Azam Mausoleum, Qaid-e-Azam Mazar, that you know is in Karachi. Okay, so this was all about this great lady, Rana Liaquat Ali Khan, the wife of the first Prime Minister of Pakistan, Liaquat Ali Khan. And she made her own mark. It wasn't just that she was the begum or the wife of the first Prime Minister of Pakistan, but she did so much for the country. So, like I had said earlier, that this is a series about the great men and women, Pakistani men and women, and I will continue to read these to you. So, see you again tomorrow.